It was an hour of terror. A bodybuilder armed with a pump-action shotgun on a shooting spree through three Western City suburbs. He first targeted the home of his pregnant former lover before his fatal face-off with police. Hannah Sinclair begins our coverage.
Underneath all that muscle, behind that smile, there was an angry man. Daniel King killed by police after a frantic string of shootings. The bodybuilder was armed with a pump-action 12-gauge shotgun, the same used by tactical officers, when he opened fire at a patrol car outside Penrith Police Station last night.
Look, I'm telling you, this is happening. This is unfolding in front of my eyes.
Oh, my God, oh, my God, oh, my God.
He's shooting the f***ing police. I've got to go, I'm scared.
Oh my God!
At this point, as we freeze vision, King is hit by police bullets, collapses to the ground, officers continuing to shoot.
Because there's a lot going on when I'm locked down.
Oh my God! Oh my God!
You can see the silhouette of the gun, and he walked up, nice and calm, just walked up towards the police station.
They just said, drop your gun, and there were shots fired. We don't know who fired first or anything like that. We just heard bang, bang, bang.
Daniel King's bizarre rampage unfolded over just 50 minutes, from Maryong at 8:45 to St Mary's Police Station half an hour later, before the deadly end in Penrith.
So then I heard police sirens, and then I had a bit of a closer look, and then next minute, bang, 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 and I thought, that's not normal.
It started at Stacey Taylor's house. She's pregnant with Daniel King's child and claims he wasn't happy about it. The 32-year-old peppered her family property with pellets when there were four adults and three children inside.
I heard a massive big bang that startled me and woke me up, and I didn't think anything of it, and I thought another bang, and it was really loud, so I hopped up and looked out my window, and I seen Daniel at the bottom of my driveway holding a shotgun and shooting fires towards my house.
From there, he drove to St Mary's Police Station and fired more rounds.
I opened the back door to let the dog out, and the next thing, there was all these gunshots. It was very loud.
When he hopped in his car, he hopped in really quick and he drove off really quickly.
Before it came to a chaotic end on Penrith's main street, a 27-year-old constable was shot in the head and other officers were injured.
One constable received pellet wounds to his head. Is currently in Westmead Hospital being treated.
The area was put into lockdown and remained a crime scene for most of the day. Workers told to stay away. Daniel King said nothing before he opened fire at police. Officers returned with at least 20 shots, and their actions will now be put under the microscope as part of an internal investigation. Police all too aware that what starts as an ordinary night can change so quickly. Hannah Sinclair, Nine News.
Nine's Tiffany Genders is at Westmead Hospital right now for us. Tiff, the injured officer was taken there last night. Any update on how he's doing?
All things considering, Mark, he's doing really well. I'm told that he's up, he's smiling and talking with family members who have been by his bedside. When the 27-year-old was brought in last night, there were still gunshot fragments lodged in the back of his head. He has undergone one round of surgery to try to remove those metal pieces, but doctors haven't yet been able to get all of them out. Now, this is quite a lot to take in for an officer who has been in the force for just over a year. Tonight, he's being praised for his bravery.
Tiff, thank you.
Hi, YouTubers, I'm Davina Smith. Well, click here to keep watching Great Nine videos and subscribe to our channel here for lots more news, analysis and exclusive content. For breaking news, see you at 9news.com.au.